Welcome to this phase four practice video. We listen in the mood of repentance, understanding we have one problem, a very severe continuity problem. So we're very humble, and we understand that spiritual practice is meant to shake us up. It is meant to shake us up, and then we settle down. Each time we do this, we get clearer and clearer, more and more and more and more accustomed to abstraction, which is the ultimate goal. And we have to accept the fact that what we are all is pure abstraction, actually. So these statements I'll be making will let them get under your skin and get to you and feel this sort of consternation, indignation, and just it's a shake-up, a spiritual shake-up designed for more and more abstraction. So we are experiencing a landslide of stability. Abiding in the all-expanded zero. With a complete collapse of all care. And seamless discordance. Feeling a fire of coolness. Watching the unmarked clock. Check the unwashed tide of traceless tracks with the breeze of ease bringing a shout of silence, taking that backward forward step into the unflipped upside downness of situation free situationness. Situationness. A playful scorelessness of non-habitual routines. An unborn birth of non-congealing coalescence. An omnidirectional steerage with rolling flotations on tireless wheels. An oblivious escape into non-derivative drama with unvectored veering and sheer, clear shining of unfreaked fearlessness. Carrying this portable potency of really, 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 really real reality with unbending diffractions of undifferentiated destinations. Experiencing these thunderstorms of tranquility through mountainous gullies of indeterminate effort. The shattering of separation in a surge of emptiness. An unchangeable breakthrough of native free naturalness. An equistatic growth of crestless certainty. A disappearance of nothing in one peaceful peace of unanswered quiet. A location-free abidance in unaskable questions. The end of beginnings, the unfoldment of spontaneity, the inexpressible answers of transcending transcendence beyond all origination. bus. We're engaged in free waiting. For waiting to wait. For free waiting. Experiencing the intoxicating intoxication of no intoxication. In the wide open church of the church of wide openness. A struggle-free non-struggle of spaced out spaciousness, of pure space-free spaciousness. We're digging a holy hole in the holy hole of holiness, washing the clean carpet of clarity. We're building the structureless temple of timelessness, riding along the wide open road of pathlessness. We're reaching into the bountiful boundaries of zero, walking upon the self-dissolving purity of the groundless ground, equating vast empty sky with self-dissolving spontaneity, reaching the endless ending of all beginnings, finding the non-apparent everywhere, floating through the sheer absence of all absence, gathering the spontaneous harvest of spontaneity, aware of where awareness is aware, sitting in the simple seat in the center of everywhere, loving what is as it is and is and is. Making a showing of non-showing in the unshown show. Explaining through no explanation that which has no explanation. Learning to lean on the non-teaching trees of totality. Dining on divinely delivered dishes of traceless, baseless taste, investing in non-developing nowness, divesting all allness of all allness right now. We're so used to hearing stories and talk and thinking we get it. We need to practice this transcendent getting of not getting. Because there's nothing to get. Reality doesn't need one to realize reality. Truth doesn't need one to affirm truth. There doesn't need to be any getter at all. So we can just be all buzzed, but we can be experiencing the all buzzed buzz of no buzz. The all buzzed buzz of no buzz. The all buzzed buzz of no buzz. And the intoxicating intoxication of no intoxication. Worshiping in the wide open church of the church of wide openness. So there's part of us that gets that doesn't get it, but it is it. And there's another part of our thinking we're trying to get it. So what we're practicing is we're getting comfortable with, I am it. I am it. I am it. I'm finding the non-apparent everywhere. I am finding the non-apparent everywhere. So part of us is perfectly comfortable with all this. There's another part of it that is like, it's like nails on a chalkboard, you know. It's this nails on a chalkboard where you just have to put up with it. And prove to ourselves it's not so bad, that it's okay to walk upon the self-dissolving purity of the groundless ground. We are walking upon the self-dissolving purity of the groundless ground. We're reaching the endless end. We're reaching the endless ending of all beginnings. We are reaching the endless ending of all beginnings. We are floating through the sheer absence of all absence. A sheer absence of all absence. Just floating through that. And again, don't try to get it. Just experience the burn. You know, that is definitely for me happening. It's like really shaken up. Just say, what do you mean? I'm floating through the sheer absence of all absence. Part of me is saying, what are you talking about? Where am I? I'm reaching into the bountiful boundaries of zero. The bountiful boundaries of zero. That's where I'm reaching. I'm reaching into those bountiful boundaries of zero. That's what I'm doing. Sitting here in the simple seat in the center of everywhere. That's where I am. I'm just sitting in the simple seat in the center of everywhere. And I'm driving. You can say driving. I'm driving along the wide open road of pathlessness. Walking along the wide open path of pathlessness, driving upon the wide open road of roadlessness. I'm riding along the pathless, wide open path of pathlessness. So I'm just riding along this wide open path of pathlessness. And I'm washing the clean carpet of clarity. I'm washing clean the clean carpet of clarity. And so on. So, meant to be a strain. This is meant to be a strain. This is skillful means. This is a firebreak. This is how we get more and more comfortable with abstraction. We're not rattled by abstraction. So when we hear abstraction, we're being pulled by abstraction. We say, oh, that's fine. I'm used to this. It's not that much of a problem for me. I'll feel a little bit of upset for sure. But I've practiced this, so it's not so bad. It's like putting your hand in cold water or hot water or whatever. Something you just get used to a little bit, and then say, oh, it's not so bad to get used to it. So we're deconditioning ourselves, actually, deconditioning ourselves from determinacy, from non-abstraction. This is like, you know, the famous Zen Buddhist Koan school, right? Which has been very big throughout many centuries in Chan Buddhism in China, and then Zen Buddhism in Japan, and then around the world. The Koan, which is, you know, what's the sound of one hand clapping? I'm listening to the sound of one hand clapping, or what is the sound? Just focus on that. Well, this is all abstraction, just a way to focus on abstraction. So I'm completely buzzed in the buzz-free buzz of no buzz. In the buzzed buzz. I'm completely buzzed in the buzzed buzz of no buzz. Yeah. But we really don't know. We only know what this means directly. See, we cannot know any of this indirectly. So all this indirectness, determinacy, based belief in process, we can't get to it based on process, can we? Based on a belief in determinacy, we can't reach. It's the unreachable reach into the boundless boundaries of zero. Bountiful boundaries of zero. We're reaching into those bountiful boundaries of zero. Now your nervous system, it has an effect on it, and that and this gradually acclimatizes you to ultimately being able to ground abstraction, as it were, here in this world without reacting to it. See, the problem is we glimpse abstraction and then we react to it. Like, what do I need to do? How do I get this? How do I reach this? Well, we're reaching into the bountiful boundaries of zero. That's what we're doing. We're riding on the wide open road of pathlessness. We're reaching the endless ending of all beginnings. We're reaching that. So I'm reaching the endless ending of all beginnings. We could say, I'm reaching the endless ending of beginningless beginnings. I'm reaching the endless endlessness of beginningless beginnings. And just hold that. I am reaching the beginningless, the ending, endless endlessness of beginningless beginnings. And this causes a real shake-up in your whole structure of expectation. But what it's going towards is allowing abstraction to opening the door, and you can see and say, this doesn't bother me, because it directly is. It just is that it is. There's no process to reach it, you see. So this loosens us up from process, belief in process. Don't get it, just experience it. Don't get it, just experience it. Don't get it, just experience it. Okay, this is plenty for this one. This is very intense. That's it.